Now we'll discuss one problem based on the magnitude of the vector product of the vectors in such a way that there are two vectors whose magnitude is given. That is, if magnitude of P is equals to 2, magnitude of Q is equals to 3, and angle between P vector comma Q vector is equals to pi by 6, and then we need to find the value of magnitude of P vector cross Q vector whole square is equals to. Now this is the value of the problem. P vector cross Q vector whole square is equals to. Now what are the given values in the problem? He gave magnitude of P is equals to 2. And he gave the magnitude of Q is equals to 3. And magnitude, the angle between P vector and as well as Q vector is equals to pi by 6. Now before going to evaluate the magnitude of P vector cross Q vector whole square, we'll write the formula for P vector cross Q vector. This can be written as magnitude of P into magnitude of Q into sin theta into n cap. So this can be written as magnitude of P is 2, magnitude of Q is 3 into sin of theta value is pi by 6 into n cap. N cap is a unit vector. So 2 into 3 is 6 into sin pi by 6 is nothing but sin 30. This can be written as 1 by 2 into n cap. So 2 1s are 2 3s are. So 3 into n cap. Therefore, P vector cross Q vector is equals to 3 into n cap. Now applying modulus on both sides. Applying magnitude on both sides. When we apply magnitude on both sides, then we'll get it as magnitude of P cross Q is equals to magnitude of 3 into n cap. Now we in the problem they gave it as magnitude of P cross Q whole square, and before that we'll separate this magnitude of 3 is 3 into magnitude of n cap. Magnitude of n cap is nothing but 3 into 1 is equals to 3. Therefore, magnitude of P cross Q vector is given by the value as 3. Now we'll do squaring on both sides. So when you do squaring on both sides, then we can write it as P cross Q magnitude whole square is equals to 3 square, that is equals to 9.